fresh, y'all. You know we never stop, we never rest, y'all. The bag of music keep the funky fresh, y'all. And we won't stop until we get y'all. Till we get y'all, say it.
good evening, and welcome to Harrington Field for tonight's special Senior Night Ceremony. Before we begin tonight's match against Simon Fraser, we'd like to take a moment to celebrate a senior class of five amazing student athletes that have helped lift the program to new heights, both on and off the field with their academic success in the classroom and the way they represent our university on the soccer pitch. This group has not only persevered as student athletes through a time when they were challenged early in their career with the pandemic, and we are proud of how they have navigated the rigors of being a student athlete. So please join us in recognizing these five student athletes and their dedication to Vikings soccer. Our first senior is joined by his mother, Amanda, father, Chris, and girlfriend, Sophie. This midfielder is enjoying his second senior night after returning for an additional year of eligibility. Elliot has appeared in 22 career games with the Vikings while making four starts and scoring one goal. Already a Western graduate, Elliot is a three-time member of the GNAC All-Academic Team. To the Harrington Field pitch for the final time, a senior midfielder for the number one, Elliot Rains. Fan and top blue. Previous Pacific. Kyoto Hiate has found a home right here in Bellingham, appearing in 26 games and making 18 starts. A member of the GNAC All-Academic Team, he is nearing his degree in management. Joined by former teammates Patrick Restum and Tegan Eldridge, please welcome to the field, senior midfielder number 14, Kyoto Hiate. Our next senior is joined by his mother, Mary Reedy, and father, David. This defender has been a key contributor for the Vikings as a five-year letter winner, appearing in 55 career games, making 45 starts since his debut during the 2019 GNAC Championship season. A standout student athlete, Theo is among the elite as a four-time GNAC All-Academic selection. Science. Please welcome to Harrington Field for the first time, senior defender from Shoreline, number 12, Theo Steinmetz. Tonight by his mother, Jennifer, father, Joseph, and sister, Mia. Here starts 5 years, appeared in 55 career games, all starts as a stalwart defender. He has recorded four assists and a pair of goals in his time as a Viking. A three-time All-GNAC academic selection, Mitchell has etched his name among the elite student athletes in the history of the program, earning the WWU Scholar Athlete of the Year Award last year. Please welcome to the field here at Harrington Field, our center back, number 17, Mitchell Hutter. Our final senior celebration is joined tonight by his grandparents, Steve, Wanda, Carrie, and Sally, Dad, Aaron, Mom, Sherry, and girlfriend, Mo. Not only one of the top goalkeepers in Western history, Brandon is also among the elite as a student athlete, as a four-time member of the GNAC All-Academic Team. He's pursuing his degree in manufacturing engineering. Between the pipes, he has appeared in 44 games while recording 16 shutouts to rank tied for second in program history. He's also among career leaders in Western men's soccer history with 22 wins. He has the lowest goals against average in program history and has one of the top save percentages. Please welcome to the field for the final time here at Harrington Field, a senior co-captain from Federal Way wearing number 0, Brandon Locke. Fans, let's give these great seniors one more round of applause for their dedication here on the soccer field as student athletes and great ambassadors for Western Washington University. Good evening, fans, and welcome to Robert S. Harrington Field on the campus of Western Washington University for tonight's Great Northwest Athletic Conference game featuring our WW Vikings and the Simon Fraser University Red Leafs. Prior to the start of tonight's 90-minute soccer match, we'll introduce the starting 11 for both teams. First for the visiting Red Leafs out of Burnaby, British Columbia. This starting 11 is announced by head coach Clint Schneider, assistant coaches Kevin Harmsey, Josh Smith, Jonas Worth, and Tyler Baldock. First for the Red Leafs, the captain, number 18, Devin O'Hay. The goalkeeper, wearing number 1, Justin Sandu. Number 2, Ty Pound. Number 3, Nico Papakirakopoulos. Number 4, Nikolai Plaksik. Number 5, Ali Zohar. Number 8, Hamish Upton. Number 9, Koji Poon. Number 10, Michael Hennessy. Number 12, Callum Beatty. And number 24, Kyle Torreson. Fans, those are your Simon Fraser University Red Leafs. And now let's meet the starting 11 for the Vikings of Western Washington. The starting 11 is announced by head coach Greg Brisbane. Assistant coaches are Chuck Pitts, Matt Zagulis, and Kyle Langowski. At goalkeeper, a senior from Federal Way and co-captain, number 0, Brandon Locke. In the midfield, a sophomore from Auburn, number 5, Ryan Roeder. In the midfield, a junior from Everett, number 6, Caden Wall. At forward, a sophomore from Sweden, number 7, Alden Jensen. At defender, a junior from Rockland, California, number 8, Jacob Sundberg. At forward, a junior from Auburn, number 10, Andrew Roeder. In the midfield, a senior from Shiga, Japan, number 14, Kyota Hiyate. In the midfield, a junior from Snohomish, wearing number 16, Aiden Fernandez. At center back, a senior co-captain from Buckley, number 17, Mitchell Utter. At defender, a freshman from Seattle, number 19, Kubel Tesfe. And at defender, a sophomore from Sweden, number 21, Joar Tidlaw. And now, fans, would you please rise if able and turn your attention to the flags to the right of the scoreboard for the playing of our national anthems, first honoring our neighbors to the north, followed by the playing of our national anthem.
Hello and welcome into Harrington Field for Western Washington University Men's Soccer Senior Day here. The third to last game of the GNAC slate for these Western Washington University Vikings, coming off a road trip, one game road trip down to SPU where they battled to a 1-1 draw with the rival Falcons and now come back for their last home game of the season, honoring five seniors today. Class of Elliot Raines, Kyoto Hiate, Theo Steinmetz, and Mitchell Hutter alongside Brandon Locke being honored pregame and playing their last game under the lights here at Harrington Field. I am Adam Race, your voice of Viking soccer, having the coverage for you here on Viking TV. Western Washington taking on GNAC leaders today, Simon Fraser University. What a season the Red Leafs are having right now. Seven-game winning streak for them as they sit atop the conference, trying to keep some distance between them and second place Western Oregon. A result today would increase that gap as Western Oregon battled to an exciting 3-3 draw in Monmouth against Seattle Pacific earlier on today. This is a red-hot Red Leafs team and a Western Washington squad that is looking for their first win since they beat their rivals SPU back here at Harrington Field about six games ago. They've had results that show the quality they have, a 2-2 draw against title contenders Western Oregon. The last one, that a game that they believe they could have won, but two equalizers from the Wolves spoiling that. Kicked off here, Simon Fraser in the white kits, attacking from right to left on your screen. The Vikings in the dark blue, attacking from left to right on your screen. Albin Janssen slotting back into the top of the formation, still looking for his first goal in GNAC play, although he does still lead the Vikings in goals scored, coming off of that GNAC Freshman of the Year campaign last season. Other than that, Coach Greg Brisbane making the change of putting Aiden Fernandez in the starting lineup right now in a right wing role, right midfielder. He provided the assist on the Vikings' lone goal against SPU last week. Gave Mitchell Hutter, senior co-captain, his first goal of the season, his second collegiate goal. SFU team, so many ways they can hurt you. Offensively, they have been just elite. Michael Hennessy currently making a bid for a GNAC Freshman of the Year. He's got 11 goals. Devin Ojea has scored a goal in each of his last seven games. This is a team scoring over two goals per game on average this season. Only draw was their GNAC opener, a 2-2 draw against Western Oregon. They've got an early corner here. Whipped in. Far post going over all the way there. Brandon Locke watches it. A day to honor seniors such as Brandon Locke. Such an incredible career Locke has had between the sticks for the Vikings. Career high in minutes this season. Two all-time, all GNAC selections. Soon to be three with the season he's having right now. And you just look at the WWU record books. He is at the top of some very significant categories. First all-time in save percentage at 7.88 and goals against average at 0.81, also top of GNAC history, making his case for one of the best netminders in Vikings men's soccer program history. Joar Tidblom lays it off to Mitchell Hutter, another long-serving player on this Vikings team being honored tonight. Top 15 all-time in minutes played. Over 4,000 minutes logged in the blue and white of the Vikings in that defensive role. Two career goals and part of an elite defensive squad this year and last year as well. Vikings only giving up a goal per game right now to rank second in the GNAC. It's been a little bit of an interesting season. The other side of the field for the Vikings on the attacking end. They lead the GNAC in shots per game, 15 per game, but are second last in goals per game, just scoring about once every game. It's just been unlucky on the attacking end of things. They're creating the chances, seeing a lot of shots go off the woodwork, incredible saves and the like. And just a season where things haven't quite gone right for the Vikings. Came into it ranked number one in the GNAC preseason poll, tied with these Simon Fraser Red Leafs. Simon Fraser has had an excellent season. Well, the Vikings, a couple stagnant offensive performances have left them closer to the bottom of the GNAC table, battling for pride right now against a really solid team. Hiate takes the ball into the box here. Hiate, another one of the seniors. He gets his cross blocked out. The Vikings have their first corner of the night here. Hiate finishing up his senior season, his second season here at Western Washington University before spending time at Hawaii Pacific and Peninsula College. Native of Shiga, Japan. Ryan Roeder hit this outswinging corner kick. The far post headed on net by Hutter and cleared off the line. Mitchell Hutter that close to a goal in the first 5 minutes of his senior night, but cleared off the line dramatically by the SFU defense. We saw earlier on today at Harrington Field, Western Washington women picking up a victory in their final GNAC game and their senior day. A 1-0 victory. You talk about the defense for the Simon Fraser squad as well, showcasing right there on the goal line clearance. Defense has been led by the goalkeeper, Justin Sandu, who right now leads the GNAC with an .831 save percentage. That's 12th in all Division II. Butter throws this one in. Flicked into the box. Janssen trying to get on the end of it. Cleared away. Redshirt freshman Krubel Tesfe finishing up an excellent first year as an everyday starter for the Vikings. The young redshirt freshman pairing of Tesfe and Sebastiano Silvetti has been very effective. Vikings 3-2-2 in home matches this year. Little dinked ball over the top, looking for Koshi Poon. Poon is muscled off the ball by Joar Tidblom, and it's sent out of bounds by Krubel Tesfe for a throw-in. So SFU trying to build off of that Western Oregon draw earlier today would be an absolutely crucial victory. That one ricochets straight off the face of the Viking defender, who looks to be shaken up at the end of it. I believe that is, not quite sure who that is on the far side. Took that, I believe it might be Jacob Sundberg. That is Sundberg, the junior defender out of Rockland, California. Took a high velocity attempted cross right off the face there, and definitely a bit worse for wear. You see this all the time in these games, and it's impressive that these players can even walk it off at all. But he's right back into the fray. This one's launched ahead, headed straight up in the air by Aiden Fernandez, the Whatcom Community College transfer in his first year for the Vikings. Cut inside, laid off now, Nikolai Plaxett. All the way back to the defense with Callum Beattie. A little bit of a lighter press today from the Vikings than we're used to seeing. Showing respect to a really high-quality Simon Fraser side who have the technical ability to break that press and create chances with the space. Andrew Roeder there going shoulder-to-shoulder with Nikolai Plaxett and drawing a whistle. Moving ahead here, and that attempted through ball is cleared away by Tidblom to the end line, out for another SFU corner kick. Vikings' best opportunity of the game came off a corner kick ahead of Mitchell Hutter. It's a team with a lot of players with an impressive aerial ability. Hutter among them, Krubel Tesfe as well, Brandon Locke, one of the best keepers you'll see at going up and getting those high lofted balls, not allowing attacking players to get ahead to it. Controls his area extremely well. This one's going to be put to the far post. Weekly headed up and over the bar. Getting to it was Plaxett, but no danger to Locke's goal. We saw the wind and the rain come in here in a flurry just as this game was about to start, but precipitation at least has calmed down. Wind still blowing in towards the north side of the field. Whistle goes against Sundberg there. SFU looking to restart things quickly off the dead ball. Sent downfield straight to Tesfaye. Roeder tries to lay it off to Hiate just over his head. Regained by SFU. Hamish Ogden scored the game winner in SFU's last game out against against NNU. Northwest Nazarene, a 1-0 shutout win. Good defensive effort and goalkeeping effort by Justin Sandu, and Hamish providing the winner. Every game crucial right now for the Simon Fraser squad, trying to capture their 8th GNAC title in program history. Punch their ticket to the postseason. No GNAC tournament in men's soccer. So for many of these teams, it's regular season title or bust. That one goes to the far side to Sundberg. Sundberg looking ahead, tried to find Hiate, straight to the SFU midfield. Instead though, Hoon with it, plays that ball ahead. Working to the top of the box now are the Red Leaves. Tesfaye providing the defense, forcing them out again. That pass finds Ogden. Ogden near side now. That one just strayed over the end line. Nico Papakirakopoulos not able to keep that one in bounds. Always a fun challenge for me as a commentator when SFU comes into town, and I can see how many times I can say Papakirakopoulos before I mess it up. 2 for 2 so far. Sandu lays it off to his center back, Callum Beattie. Red Leafs build from the back down the left side. Plaxett, long ball, switching play over the top. Quality ball as well. It's at Hennessy's feet now. Now to the far wing. Looking for space to cross it in. Trying to work around Sundberg. It goes to the far post off the crossbar. It stays out. The clearance by Tidblom. It's not all the way out yet. And now finally sent straight up into the air. Aiden Fernandez there. It was Devin O'Hare, the captain, who had the header. He sent straight down into the turf, trying to bounce it back up into the net, but it went off the crossbar, and Tidblom did just enough to clear the danger. Most dangerous opportunity of the match so far for SFU. They send it in again, this time easy pickings for Tidblom. Now offside flag is up on the far side against Kyle Torreson, the freshman out of North Vancouver, BC. That top line, Koji Poon, alongside Devin O'Hale, some of the most dangerous you'll find in this conference. 2.3 goals per game. Of course, the number 10, Hennessy, extremely notable freshman for these Red Leafs, scored 5 goals in a game earlier this season against St. Martin's, just the 3rd time in conference history a player has scored 5 goals in one match. First time it's happened in a conference game. Johnson applying the pressure, trying to get onto Sandu here, who's just outside of his box. Really well done under pressure there by Sandu to take it down and get it to his defender. Team committed to playing it out of the back and not booting it long. They certainly have the technical quality to do it. skip pass to the far end of the field. Working across midfield now, Hennessy. On the wing, lifts it in, headed away by Tidblom as far as Sundberg. His attempted clearance is deflected out for a Vikings goal kick. So a lot of the attacking third possession early on here going to the Red Leafs. Last time these teams faced off in Burnaby, it was a 3-1 SFU victory. Goal scorers were Hennessy, Poon, and O'Hea for SFU. And Sebastiano Silvetti, the redshirt freshman, picked up his first collegiate goal in that match to make it 3-1. Cleaning up the leftovers of a shot that was saved off the foot of Edgar Serrano. Hutter, last year's Western Washington University Men's Student Athlete of the Year, four-time all-academic selection, an exemplary student athlete. Ogden, back line now with Beattie. Gets it back to Ogden. He's pressed by Caden Wall. Vikings not getting a huge share of the ball early on here in the first 15 minutes. It's been mostly possessed by the Red Leafs. Such a quality men's soccer program for so many years up in Simon Fraser University up in Burnaby. 7 GNAC championships. Moving ahead here is Poon. Running straight at that back line. Fakes the shot to get around Tidblom. Tried to lay it off to the near side. It was taken away by Fernandez. Now SFU get it right back through O'Hea. O'Hea tried to get it to the corner. Blocked away by Aiden Fernandez. And Hiate skipping ahead across midfield. He's got Roeder on his left and Janssen on his right. Takes it himself. Now gives it to Roeder. Andrew Roeder at the edge of the box, making space for himself, driving to the end line, keeps it in just barely, and now it is going to be whistled for going over that end line for a SFU goal kick, but that is the explosive dribbling we've seen all season from Andrew Roeder, able to create goals when he gets into that position, one-on-one at the edge of the box. Also not afraid to try to finish those off from a tight angle. That time tried to square it, wasn't able to do it in time. Goal scorers last time we were at Harrington Field in that 2-2 draw with Western Oregon. Kyle Serrano with a screamer to the top corner from the top of the box, and Eric Bunnell finishing off a nice run by Alvin Janssen. Really a game that showcased the talent that this Western team does have. It just hasn't fallen their way this season. They were able to play a GNAC leading Western Oregon squad to a convincing 2-2 draw, a game they really feel they should have won. Two shots in the match for Simon Fraser so far, just one for the Vikings. It was an impressive save by Sandu that kept that one shot from hitting the back of the net. Still the best chance the Vikings have had. Against a good side like this, those set piece opportunities are what Western Washington may have to rely on for their better goal scoring opportunities. Certainly a team with the dead ball ability to take advantage of those set pieces. This one lifted ahead. Ogden isn't able to put it into the middle, but does win the throw in working against Hutter. Throw in duty here is Papakirakopoulos. Wall battling for it. Gets it off his man and now sends it ahead to Hiate. Well done to win back possession by Caden Wall. Making the start today. He's been a squad rotation player this year. He's always shown a good ability in winning the ball back when he's been on the field. Powerful shot as well. Dead ball specialist. Wall switches play all the way to the far side. Sundberg's waiting for it. Challenge, and it's won away by Torreson. tries to lift it down to start a quick counter. O'Hea was not quick enough to make the run, though. Lock comes all the way out, distributes it to Mitchell Hutter. Fernandez swings it over the wall. Tesfaye now. Vikings looking to work down the left side through Sundberg and Roeder. Now they cycle it back around. Hutter takes it across midfield himself. His attempted pass forward is blocked. He's going to have to rush back into defense here, but the attempted ball is stolen away by Wall and Ryan Roeder, younger of the two Roeder brothers. Andrew and Ryan both having solid seasons here. Two of the top scoring players on this Vikings roster behind only Albin Janssen. Janssen went off to a torrid start in non-conference play this season, but still looking for his first GNAC goal with three games remaining in the GNAC slate. A lot of the reason the Vikings have been on a bit of a goal-scoring drought is Janssen in a bit of a funk. When he's on, he's just about the most dangerous attacker in the conference. Showed that last year as he led the conference in goals en route to a Freshman of the Year award. And now a Freshman of the Year candidate playing against the Vikings in Hennessy. Jim Wagenaar, another lead candidate for the conference's premier freshman, came in a couple weeks back and scored against the Vikings in a 1-0 defeat at the hands of Northwest Nazarene University. A lot of young scoring talent in this conference in 2023. That one just stays in on the far touchline from the header. Ryan Roeder fighting for it. It's taken away by SFU. O'Hea moving ahead with it. Opportunity over the crossbar, just barely on a first-time opportunity. Another dangerous move ahead by SFU. That was Poon getting on the end of it, and just getting under it a little bit. Sundberg flicks it ahead. Torreson. Now Ogden. Ogden guarded by Hiate, forced to play it back. That through ball picked up cleanly by Rubel Tesfaye. The 1-2 doesn't work the other way for the Vikings, and SFU have it back. Hennessy's ball through is taken away. Good tackle there by Tesfaye. Quick reaction. Sticking the leg out to stop that one. Long throw. Trying to find the run of Zohar, but cleared away. Zohar knew he was offside, so he let that one run by him. Ryan Roeder on it now near the end line. Puts his foot through it. Floating up in the air for Janssen with a knuckleball. Janssen whiffed on the header. Wind coming into effect on these aerial balls. Blowing in south to north. Ogden with it. Hiate and Sundberg, the defenders on that side, now plays it back to Zohar. Switch near side, Plaxett. Sent straight up in the air and out. That'll be a goal kick, Western Washington. They just want to reset and get a solid string of possession going. A team that does enjoy building from the back through the center backs and through an excellent distributing goalkeeper in Brandon Locke, one of the best distributors from net you'll find in the conference and in the division. had an assist last season on a long throw out to Alvin Janssen. Shown off the arm a number of times this year, and the leg as well. This one far beyond midfield. Kept inbounds by Andrew Roeder. Back to Sundberg. Trying to swing it through for Alvin Janssen just beyond his feet as the rain and the wind start to come down a little more here. O'Hea running that one through, trying to find Hennessy, just a little too much on it, and Tidblom's able to clear. Ryan Roeder almost made the interception. Now he does come up with it. His brother Andrew, back heel flick, tries to get it back to Ryan, and now a harsh sliding tackle draws a whistle from Ryan Roeder. Won't be a card. Both players look no worse for wear. SFU throwing down the left side now. Thrown in by Apakirakopoulos, just beyond the reach of Poon. And now out towards Andrew Roeder, touches it over to Kyoto Hiate. Vikings trying to break in transition here. Long ball ahead to Janssen. It's 1-on-3. Janssen's not winning that battle. It's taken away by Plaxett. Plaxett leading the Red Leafs in minutes played this year, leading from the back. This excellent defensive squad they've put together, excellent on both sides of the field. Could say the highlight is that 2.3 goals per game that they are scoring. Vikings have done well so far, keeping them out of the back of the net with 20 minutes remaining in the first half. Both teams still looking for the opener here at Harrington. Ryan Roeder swings it all the way across to Jacob Sundberg, keeps it inbounds. Little touch off the chest. Caden Wall towards midfield, looking for options ahead. Now gets it back to Mitchell Hutter. Vikings still looking for a way beyond their back line. Now the press does come from the Red Leafs, three white shirts ahead. That missed pass from Sundberg is going to be headed up towards O'Hea and Tesfaye. Tesfaye is going to win that aerial duel and get it back to his keeper in lock. Quickly distributed to Mitchell Hutter. Through ball wide of Kyoto Hiate. See our first changes of the match here. Coming onto the field, another senior in Elliot Rain, celebrating his second senior day of his career. Decided to use his extra year of eligibility after being honored on senior day last season. Coming back in. He'll slot into that left side wing role, replacing Jacob Sundberg. Hiate ahead to Janssen, booted back. Only as far as Wall. Rain's on the ball again. Roeder looks for options ahead. Plays it horizontally instead to Wall. Vikings slowly inching that line forward. Hutter, early ball sent in long and claimed by Sandu, who rolls it out quickly, trying to start a counterattack for the Red Leafs. O'Hea with it. O'Hea working against Ryan Roeder. Keeps it ahead towards Ogden. Ogden dispossessed very well there by Joar Tidblom, and his ball is taken away by Ty Pound before it got to Andrew Roeder. Pound moves it across midfield himself. Defender tracking ahead. Gets it to the wing now. sent into the middle. And Fernandez in a defensive role today. Plays more of midfield naturally, but he's done very well in defense. Handful of clearances, intercepted passes, made the clearance there. And Tesfaye sliding down and stopping that through ball. Roeder to Reigns, back to Roeder. Andrew Roeder down the wing now. Space ahead of him to run. Janssen's making the run ahead. Does get there, working against Ty Pound. Johnson tries to put the moves on him, and his pass is taken away by Hennessy, tracking all the way back in defense there. Still just one shot in the match for the Vikings. It was the Hutter header from the corner kick. Coach Greg Brisbane calling for his team to keep the horizontal movement of the ball, look for openings ahead. Hutter ahead to Ryan Roeder, dinks it to Wall. Well, timed pass to Aiden Fernandez. Three white shirts around him immediately. Vikings patiently building up here, winning space up the field yard by yard. More sustained possession than we saw from them earlier in the match, so positive signs from the Vikings. Still deadlocked at 0-0. Tidblom to Tesfaye. Fernandez. Ahead to Wall. Janssen on it now. Janssen whips it in. Roeder wasn't able to get the header away. Headed away by Pound instead. All the way back to Ryan Roeder. Yate resets to Hutter. This is a great string of possession we're seeing here from the Vikings. A lot of very quality passing in there. It finally slips beyond Yate. Out of the Vikings' grasp. Walk way out of his box here. Boots it downfield towards Yate. Heads it back up to Ryan Roeder. His ball is sent back. Janssen made the run inside while the pass came behind him from Hiate. We're going to see a number of substitutions from each side here. Three for each side. Eric Bunnell picked up his first goal against Western Oregon last time out at Harrington Field. He comes onto the field. Diego Alvarado alongside Quau Serrano joining him. Quau, the other goal scorer against Western Oregon. Alvarado, the striker, looking for his first goal of the season. Serrano, excellent dead ball player. Division I transfer out of Northern Illinois University. Seattle Sounders Academy product has really shown that technical ability all year. Hugely positive impact every time he steps on the field. That pass from Ryan Roeder is under hit, taken away. Collision at the midfield between Reigns and Cole Topin. No whistle. Vikings take possession over. Bunnell's running ahead. He was in an offside position. Let it go all the way to Sandu. Back with Sandu. Dinks it back up to the substitute, Devi Romero. Romero's pass near side to Plaxit. Another substitute here, Mads Poulsen. Back to Plaxit. Plaxit lets it go out and takes the throw in. Romero. Intercepted by Hutter. Ryan Roeder not able to take that one cleanly. A giveaway and a ball ahead. Tesfaye once again going to the ground and clearing it up in the air. Copen working against Reigns, and that'll end up in a goal kick for the Vikings. Word around Viking Athletics right now. Basketball season starting out for men and women. Women starting the regular season slate this coming week at Carver Gym. It's this one. He's flicked ahead. O'Hay running onto it. He's going to let that go out for a corner. Western men's basketball off to a 2-0 start after going perfect in the D2 Canadian Tip-Off Classic in Langley this weekend. GNAC women's cross-country team winning the West Region Championship today as well. Congratulations to Vikings cross-country for what has been an excellent season. Viking volleyball playing right now in Carver Gym. Zen Hill on the call over there. Corner sent into the middle. Player goes down, and Locke watches that one just trickle over the crossbar. It'll be a goal kick. Put that one too close to the net. Ryan Roeder, looking for options, finds an open Caden Wall. Crossfield to Reigns. Reigns tries to chip it over his defender. Can't do it initially, but does get it to Bunnell. Bunnell, bodied down. Colt Open called for the foul there. Vikings, angle like this, are able to put it into the box, try to get a flick-on header. It'll just be a two-player wall for SFU. Ryan Roeder looks like he's going to be the one to take this free kick. Wow, Serrano jogs towards the top of the box. Ball comes out to him. He can certainly provide a strike. We've seen it before. Roeder, low-driven ball in, flicked on, and just beyond the reach of Krubel Tesfe. It did take a deflection off an SFU defender. Tesfe frustrated. He wasn't able to get a piece of that and send it on frame. He was all alone after the flick, but stuck out the foot to no avail. Will end in a Vikings corner, though. Roeder over to take. The rain starts to come down a little more heavily here. Already seen a couple slips out there. Could lead to an opportunity going either way. Roeder sends in the outswinger. Far post. Headed on goal and just wide. Kept inside by Ryan Roeder, his cross deflected out for what will be another corner kick. So we'll do it again here from the near side. Vikings are 2 for 3 on getting header opportunities off of these corner kicks. See if they can do it again here. Sent in by Roeder, near post this time, got beyond the reach of Janssen and sent away by Poulsen. Roeder's going to keep it in, put it into the middle, headed straight up in the air, still in the box, and now finally cleared away by Zohar. Tidblom in a collision there, and working ahead is Poulsen. Poulsen tried to put it into the middle, just mishit that one. Good defensive work by Reigns and Tidblom, tracking back in transition. Stop the counterattack. Seven minutes, 40 seconds remaining in this first half. Vikings, they found a foothold in this one early on. SFU controlling a lot of the possession, but good run here by Western, creating their own opportunities, keeping the Red Leafs off the ball. Simon Fraser shifting into a five-player back line out of possession right here, trying not to give any space to pacey strikers like Albin Janssen, who's on it now in the corner, breaking into the box, tried to get it around Zohar, took a deflection and then cleared away. Roeder ahead to Wall. Back to Hutter. Hutter, well done to get around the press. Quow. Driving towards the corner. On the deck into the middle. Bunnell has a shot. Swing and a miss there from Eric Bunnell. Not able to make contact. Off a little popped up half volley. Ryan Roeder in the middle. Alvarado. He's looking towards goal. Puts it into Bunnell instead. First touch was a little bit off. Andrew Roeder, Elliot Raines here on it. Raines driving in. Gets out to Ryan Roeder. Squaring up for a shot himself. This one going wide left. Kudos to Roeder for finding the space for that shot. Tried to curl it, but didn't strike it sweetly enough to put it on net. So we'll restart with the goal kick by Sandu. Tesfaye. Hutter dinks it ahead, looking for the run of Janssen or Bunnell. Neither of them made it, though. A little shove in the back there from Poulsen on Hutter. It will draw a whistle. That ball stuck up on the roof. Tough spot. They'll have to get a new game ball. Back in play here. Hutter looking forward and now back to Tidblom. Tidblom's played a lot at the fullback role, but slotting into center back starting this match off. He's had a really solid sophomore season here after a convincing freshman campaign as well. The defender out of Sweden. This long ball is looking for Janssen, but Sandu will claim it. Under five remaining in the first half. Still nil-nil. Just five shots between the two teams. These are the two teams in the GNAC averaging the first and second most shots, both of them around 15 per game. So it's been a very stuck-in battle by both of these squad standards. SFU moving ahead here, and the ball to Hennessy was just a bit too long and into the waiting arms of Locke. Hutter trying to curl one ahead for Quow. Quow applying the pressure to Blacksit and now to Sandu. Short ball out, almost went straight to Diego Alvarado. Didn't react quick enough to it. Surely didn't expect the distribution from Sandu to be right on the ground to him. Thrown in by Hutter, trying to get it to Bunnell. This falls to Ryan Roeder instead, now to Wall. Vikings cycled around that back line again. As always, patient in the buildup, not rushing into anything, trying to build through those wide areas. Wall's pass is cut out, intercepted by Zohar, and then Wall gets back, sends it out for a throw. We're going to see some 2 minutes remaining, just some changes here for the visitors. Christian Camuzzi coming on, as well as Ryan Torreson. Redshirt junior in Kamuzi. Defender out of Coquitlam, BC. And Torreson, the freshman midfielder out of North Vancouver. Tidblom wins that aerial duel, and Wall sends it towards midfield. Plaxit and Alvarado doing battle. Alvarado's going to be whistled for a little too handsy on that one-on-one battle with Plaxit. Free kick SFU. Play switch to the opposite end. Reigns there in defense. Now Ryan Roeder, the main line of defense, against Torreson. Back to Topin. Topin can't control it. Under pressure from Reigns, out for a throw. Rain picks up here. Wind has died down just a bit. At least not raining sideways as we saw earlier on in this match.
One minute remaining.
Definitely one of the wetter games we've seen here at Harrington this season. A year where we have been blessed with very clear weather for Viking soccer games. Here on the last one of the season, not so lucky. Alvarado outpaced there by Topin. 30 seconds remaining. Vikings last looks in the half, trying to steal a go-ahead goal. Bunnell. Wall. Dinks it ahead over the head of Quow. Topin pressured by Alvarado, does well to escape to the corner and try to move it down the wing. Long ball ahead, goes out of bounds. Vikings got to move very quickly here with 10 seconds on the clock. See if they've got one last shot left in it. Gets into Alvarado. Alvarado back to goal. His attempted ball forward is blocked. And the long one from Tesfaye will lead to nothing as it is 0-0 at the break. Western Washington playing a very high-quality Simon Fraser squad. Tough in that first half. Five shots between the two teams. A stuck-in battle as Lorraine comes down here in Bellingham, Washington. We'll have the last 45 of Vikings men's soccer in 2023 here at home in just about 15 minutes. Don't go away yet.
With my team, keep it moving and doing it right. Thank you.
Welcome back in here to Harrington Field. Western Washington and Simon Fraser deadlocked at 0-0 after the first 45 minutes of action. Just five shots between the two teams. Started off all Simon Fraser possessing the ball. First 10, 15, 20 minutes. It seemed to be all red leaves. But then Western Washington able to switch something up, maintain possession, work slowly up the field, building from the back and getting opportunities of their own. Best chance of that first half for the Vikings was a Mitchell Hutter-headed shot on goal off a corner kick, denied only by a great save by Red Leaf senior goalkeeper Justin Sandu, increasing on an already impressive save percentage, close to 800, which is one of the best not only in the GNAC, but in all of Division II, top 15 in the nation. He kept it at 0-0, and the crossbar denied Simon Fraser of an opening later on in the half. Ball that was headed on goal by Devin O'Hea, just staying out via the crossbar, and then a Gerard Tidblom clearance. And that's where we find ourselves at 0-0. Western Washington here on senior night, celebrating a five-player senior class and trying to play spoiler against an SFU squad coming into this game, ranked atop the GNAC, leading the conference in goals scored and goals against. A very formidable side the Vikings have certainly played to tonight. Really liked what we saw the second half of that first period of play. If they can continue that, they could be headed towards a positive result here on senior night against probably the best team they've played all season at home at Harrington Field. SFU trying to capitalize off of dropped points by Western Oregon earlier on today in their match against Seattle Pacific at home in Monmouth. Those two teams alone atop the GNAC standings right now. A two-horse race for the conference title. And it would be a big 3 points if SFU can find a winner and hold on in this last 45. See what the Vikings have to say about that. So you restart here in just a moment with the Vikings kicking off. Eric Bunnell stays in at that central striker position. Similar look to what we saw the Vikings have going into the half. They'll be in the dark blue, attacking from right to left on your screen. Simon Fraser in the white jerseys, attacking from left to right for these last 45. Whistle goes, and we are underway. Last 45 minutes of home soccer in 2023 here at Harrington Field. Pass from Tesfaye early on is picked off by Hamish Ogden. Ogden coming off that game winner. He scored against Northwest Nazarene, Red Leaf's last game out, a crucial shutout win against a quality Nighthawks team. This time, Torreson on the ball. And back to Zohar. Zohar ahead. Ogden flicks it in. Torreson, long lofted cross over everything. Reigns heads it away at the far end. Chases after and gets to it. Well played there by Elliott. Reigns off the bounding ball. Gets it to Bunnell. Wall, heavy touch ahead. Wet conditions out there. Slippery field, slippery ball as well. Might lead to some mistakes on either side. See if a slip-up leads to a quick break for the Vikings or the Red Leafs. And once again, just before the play started, the rain picked up just as we saw at the beginning of the game. Steadily coming down here, South Campus of Western Washington University. Conditions, natives of Pacific Northwest, Burnaby to Bellingham, are surely familiar with. That's a nice ball ahead, trying to get it to Torreson, but Janssen was first to react all the way back, and a long ball ahead by Locke gets all the way to Eric Bunnell. Bunnell ahead with Alvarado. Some stepovers in the box. Works it onto his right foot. Lays it off for Alvarado. His shot is in! Diego Alvarado, his first goal of the year. And the Vikings lead the GNAC leaders. And once again, some excellent distribution out of the back from Brandon Locke. Brandon Locke, if he is credited with an assist on that one, it'll be back-to-back years with an assist for the Viking goalkeeper. And in his last Harrington Field match, a beautiful piece of distribution to get ahead to Bunnell. Stopped play up in the box, laid it off for Alvarado. A good finish just beyond Sandu. Got a touch to it, but not enough to keep it out. Vikings lead 1-0. What a statement that is against such a quality side, showing why the Vikings were ranked atop the GNAC preseason poll alongside the Red Leafs. They have really played at the best of their abilities for the last 30 or so minutes of in-game time, making the Red Leafs pay in transition. Great moment for striker Diego Alvarado, picking up his first goal of the season. Bunnell with an assist after scoring in his last time at Harrington. Brandon Locke, if he hadn't already added enough accolades to his Western Washington career, picking up his second career point on the assist. I don't have the numbers right now for goalkeeper assists in Vikings history, but I'm sure two is up there. Tesfaye, ball ahead, trying to find Janssen, showing off the pace to get there and apply pressure to pound, but Sandu got there first. And this is a Simon Fraser squad conceding less than a goal per game. Vikings only needed three shots to put one in the back of the net. For a Vikings team that's scoring on the season a goal every 15 shots, it's a great turnaround and a great sign. Bunnell battling for it. Forces it back to Sandu. Hennessy got a touch to it. Perhaps a touch a little high up the arm there. It'll be whistled back for a Vikings free kick. Locke boots it downfield again, this time looking for Rains. Into the middle with Hennessy. GNAC, freshman of the year contender this year. His pass is headed away by Janssen. He's in much of a more defensive position in this half as Janssen. Almost acting as a fullback to start off this half. Hennessy ahead. Gets it off to the captain, O'Hea. Fed back to Hennessy. Heavy touch brings it to the edge of the box. Sliding down and taking out Albin Janssen. Play continues. Far end of the box. Shot comes in. Blocked away by the SFU attacker. O'Hea still on it. Deflected. Kept away by Tesfaye. Hennessy with it now. Pressure still on the Viking net. Another shot blocked. Hennessy still on it. And now deflected out for an SFU corner kick. So a flurry of opportunities staved off by the Vikings. Janssen in the end sent it out of play. Several shots blocked in there. Chances for Papakirakopoulos. Chances for O'Hea. And then for Hennessy. None of them getting to Brandon Locke. Vikings would love to hang yet another shutout on a GNAC opponent this year. Add to their resume, add to the resume of Mitchell Hutter and Brandon Locke, the two captains of this defense. And what a statement it would be against this high-flying SFU squad. The Burnaby boys have been tough to beat. 7 games in a row they've won. That's in danger right here against a convincing Viking squad. Sent all the way over the top and headed away by Rains. Alvin Janssen wins the free kick there. He's in a little bit of pain on the end of it. Looks to have pulled up muscle in the leg. Back up to his feet here. A little bit of pain in that right ankle. Looks like he'll walk it off, though. Locke set to take this free kick. Launches it up to Buttle. Can't win that aerial duel against Zohar. Rains takes that one off the face, goes right to Buttle. Buttle looks up towards goal, has a shot way over. Buttle far too much on that one and under that one. And Albin Janssen's going to check out here. Perhaps still hobbled from the injury we saw a moment before. He'll be replaced by Jacob Sundberg. SFU looking to build out of the back here. Sundberg, fresh legs off the bench, applying the pressure. SFU pinned back into their own corner and now forced to just send it ahead. Vikings take back over with a throw. Sundberg on the return from Bunnell. Quow. On the deck, into the middle, top of the box. Wall's going to chase after this one and get to it. Back into the mix. Headed away. Doing the work was Pound. O'Hea, 4 blue shirts around him, squirms his way out. Gets it to Hennessy. That through ball was intended for Koji Poon, who the Vikings have done a good job of keeping out of this match. Poon scored last time these two teams met in Burnaby, that 3-1 win for Simon Fraser. Poon, Hennessy, and O'Hea, the goal scorers in that one. All three of them kept at bay so far with just under 36 minutes left in this one. Locke lifts it downfield. flicked on by Reigns. Bunnell's not going to be able to get to that one before it goes out for a Red Leafs throw. So Vikings really just playing spoiler in this match, trying to make it a great senior night for the senior class of five. But SFU, this game means more than anything as they try to extend their lead atop the GNAC. Bunnell takes it back, tries to get it to Quow just beyond his left foot. You got to think there's a lot of desperation of this SFU squad to come into Harrington and extend this winning streak to seven. Red Leafs still undefeated in GNAC play. Only draw was against Western Oregon to open up the GNAC slate. Tidblom heads away that one. Reigns plays it over to Tesfaye. Just beyond Roeder, Zohar into Ohea, looks up towards goal, has a shot with the left foot, saved by Locke, sprawling to his left and cleared away. Brandon Locke getting it done on the offensive end with the assist and now making a save down to his left side, forcing the corner kick. Ohea, the captain, squared up for that one. Got a good amount behind it, but kept it too close to the Vikings captain and goalkeeper. This one sent right at Locke. Can't get a clean punch on it. Still in the mix. Ohea turning and shooting over the bar. Frustration from the Red Leafs captain. Two chances back to back. He's not able to convert. Uncharacteristic there from Locke to not get a clean punch on it. Usually in total control of those lofted balls into the mix, but doesn't get punished for it. Vikings take the goal kick. And the rocket of a left foot that Brandon Locke has being aided right now by that wind blowing in from the south. Able to kick it just about three quarters of the way down the field from his own penalty area. Sundberg into Alvarado. Nifty touch to get around the defender, fighting for position. Is able to try to keep it in bounds, but did just drift over that line. Goal kick taken very quickly by Sandu. Simon Fraser still trying to find an answer. All saying the most important minutes of the match are the first and last 5 minutes of every half, and the first 5 minutes after a goal is scored. Vikings have made it through that. Still holding on here. Free kick for SFU here. A little pulling and shoving on the jersey. Zohar and Papakirakopoulos standing over this one. Papakirakopoulos, the option with the left foot. Zohar is now gone into the mix. Papakirakopoulos, low service in. Touched away by Caden Wall. Ryan Roeder tries to spring Alvarado the other way. Reigns sprinting ahead, providing the run. That ball's a little bit behind him. We'll have to slow up to get to it. And that'll dampen down the momentum of that transition. Vikings in possession, though. Long switch from Hutter right to the chest of Bunnell. Perfectly placed. Ryan Roeder ahead to Bunnell. Sundberg, option on the wing. They get it to him. Driving to the end line. Putting it into the middle. Dangerous. Edge of the box. Reigns has a shot. And the Vikings have doubled their lead. Elliot Reigns scores on senior night. 2-0 Western Washington. Just the second goal of Elliot Reigns' Vikings career. And all of a sudden, Western Washington are 2-0 up on Simon Fraser. What a moment for Elliot Reigns. First time perfectly slotted into the right side netting on a low shot. Can't do it any better than that. And now the Vikings have two goals on just 4 shots. It was great delivery in by Sundberg. Got through the mix and found Reigns all alone on the other side of the box. Did not hesitate to put that one away. This is the kind of play we saw from the Vikings in non-conference play. Had a stand against Regis and Colorado School of Mines. They won those two games by an aggregate score of 5-0. Went a bit cold once the GNAC season started, but this is the Western Washington squad. We've been waiting to see it. Harrington in GNAC play. Blocked by Sundberg as that cross. Alvarado moving the other way. Vikings looking to build up another counterattack. Alvarado cuts it back. Pass from Wall is cut out easily by Hennessy to the ire of Greg Brisbane. On the deck, straight to Brandon Locke. Easy pickings for the Vikings goalkeeper. Not required to get a shutout to hold on to this win, but a shutout certainly would be an excellent way to end senior night. Vikings are going to have to hold on for just under 30 minutes against a team scoring over 2 goals per game. We know Simon Fraser has the firepower to get back into this one. Vikings cannot go to sleep for even a second here with this 2-goal lead. Bunnell. Stepover is trying to make space for himself. Gets it back to Sundberg and Tesfaye. Going to cycle it around the back here. And once again, Western doing an excellent job right after the goal of maintaining the pressure, maintaining possession, not letting SFU strike back quickly. That long ball from Reigns, mishit now for a goal kick. So a couple of first-time goal scorers as Hutter puts on the move there. His ball ahead, though, is over the top of the intended target. First-time scorers in Alvarado and Reigns this season. Couldn't come at a better time for the Vikings as Tidblom steps in to make that block. Vikings led 2 separate occasions against Western Oregon last time out. Another quality side, but both times the Wolves were able to battle back. Both of those were 1-goal leads, though. Hennessy. We're against Ryan Roeder. Rain picks up. Top of the box now. Near side. Isaac Strand. Strand cannot corral it out for a Vikings throw-in. Roeder gets it ahead to Quow. Quow puts the ball behind him and takes the contact. A little bit of afters between Zohar and Roeder. Zohar walks off now. Quow excellent at elusiveness with the ball, forcing fouls. We saw him draw a penalty the last time the Vikings were victorious. That was against SPU here at home. Quow draw a penalty in that match that Ryan Roeder converted. Sandu has to come all the way out here at the edge of his box to clear it. On rushing was Alvarado. Ball sent up towards Sundberg for the throw-in. First one was up on the hill and looks like they're not going to be able to go get it. So the replacement coming from behind Sandu's net. Bundle to Sundberg. Lofted in, nobody in there besides Sandu, who catches it and will redistribute out. Vikings, a team coming into this game scoring just one in every 15 shots. They've scored on 50% of their shots in this match. Excellent efficiency. They want another one here ahead with Alvarado. He's dispossessed. SFU trying to find an answer, but Western right now, they are controlling play, not letting the Red Leafs anything ahead as Brandon Locke sends a souvenir into the stands. We're going to see substitutions here for the Red Leafs. Checking back in is Ryan Torreson. SFU working ahead with a couple throw-ins here. Halfway to the Vikings net. Thrown in towards Zohar. Back to Zohar here. Puts it into the middle. Poon trying to get it in, and it's clear just as it got to the middle. Now Ohea's cross is blocked by Sundberg, and out for another throw-in. Once again, Viking defense standing tall right now in a low block. Trying to withstand this current SFU attack. Something GNAC teams have not been able to do very effectively this year, letting in a boatload of goals against these Red Leafs. Ohea. Top of the box now. Platts it. Far end. Whipped in. Just tipped by Sundberg. On the deck. Cleared by Krubel Tesfaye. Second shot is blocked on the deck by Sundberg again. Playing from the ground to make that block. Taken back by Zohar. Into the middle. Deflected off of Sundberg. And a quick reaction from Brandon Locke to avoid what would have been a very unfortunate own goal off the deflection from Sundberg, which looked dangerous. But a good reaction save from Locke. SFU nine shots now on the match. Forced three saves out of Locke. Another excellent match is that one. Box to box from Brandon Locke. My goodness. Incredible power in that left boot on the drop kick. Pound. Feeding it ahead. Trying to find Poon. Poon running with it. Deflected away by Reigns. Reigns, he wants to start a counter. Now stops it up. Walled Alvarado just near midfield. Bunnell. Runner on the near side is Sundberg. That pass might be a little bit ahead of him as it is just out. Thrown to the back line. Callum Beatty. Gets it over to fellow defender Plaxett. Vikings press is penning in the Red Leafs right now. Touches beyond midfield have been tough to take for the Red Leafs. That one cleared away by Tesfaye. He's been a no-nonsense defender tonight. Anything that comes near him, he's sending straight back to the SFU side of the field. He's gone to ground a few times, sliding in to cut out through balls. Another brick wall performance thus far by Tesfaye, the redshirt freshman. Wow, Serrano thought he dispossessed Zohar there, but the whistle went. Headed over towards Torreson. Plays it back to Hennessy. Hennessy against the challenge of Alvarado and Quao. And once again, the whistle goes against Quao. He is incensed on that one, but Zohar takes it out quickly. Long shot comes in. Deflected in the box. Tidblom, quick to react, gets it out. And all the way across midfield by Quao. These center backs today of Tesfaye and Tidblom have been right where they've needed to be. Every time the Vikings need that big clearance. Red Leafs working down the far wing now. Hutter in defense. Reins over to help. SFU does get it into the middle. O'Hea was on it, but it was whistled for going over that end line. So Reins and Hutter do the defensive work to stop that attack and give the Vikings a goal kick. We're going to see some subs, a trio here for the Vikings. It'll be Albin Janssen, Kyoto Hiate, and Aiden Fernandez coming back in. Three starters. Elliot Reins comes off to a raucous round of applause, as does Diego Alvarado, the two goal scorers checking out, as well as Kyle Serrano. So now the Vikings' leading goal scorer back on the field in Albin Janssen. Hiate, a player with a couple assists on the year, back in. And Aiden Fernandez, who had the assist on the only goal in the Vikings' last contest against SPU. Fernandez, mostly a defensive presence in that first half, but playing far up the field here in a right wing position. Slotting in where Elliot Reins was. Reins was able to find a goal there. See if Fernandez has similar ability to do so. Ryan Roeder. Ball roll to maintain possession. Bunnell tries to work it round a jumble of defenders. Can't do so, but it pops out back to Ryan Roeder. Roeder looks up towards goal, still under his feet. Gets it out to Hiate, has a shot of his own off the crossbar. Kyoto Hiate, that close from his first goal of the season. It had Sandu beat, but just a little too much air under it. Tipped off the crossbar and out for a goal kick. Under 20 minutes remaining. Vikings still holding this 2-0 lead. Head referee asking SFU to back up that throw in. Torreson in. Straight out of bounds to the delight of the crowd. Sundberg ahead. SFU literally have to battle for every foot of space out there. Vikings are doing excellently right now. Hiate in the corner. Sundberg, service into the middle, just beyond the foot of Janssen, and all the way out to Wall on the far end. He's played a good chunk of minutes tonight. He's been solid. Ryan Roeder touches it past Zohar and gets it around Hennessy as well. Sundberg on the near side. Cross to the top of the box. Buttle tries to bring it down. Tried to get to Janssen as well. It was just beyond it. Roeder to Bunnell, looks up towards net, fakes the shot. Sliding tackle by Zohar, brings it all the way back out to Wall. Vikings knocking on the door right now, pushing the SFU Red Leafs into a low block of their own. 1-2 pass finds Hutter, who has a shot right at Sandu. Mitchell Hutter, not a player afraid to have a shot of his own, scored a screamer in the game against SPU last week. That one, not too far off, good power on it, but too close to Sandu. It's been a tough match for Sandu, who's having a historic season by his own standards with a save percentage around 80%. But the Vikings today have pushed that save percentage down to now 66 on the night. Hiate goes down. That will draw a foul. Little kick in the leg. Back up to his feet. Hiate, such an underappreciated part of this Vikings squad. Just the engine that makes this teamwork end to end. Loved by teammates and fans alike. It's been a pleasure to have him here at Harrington for these 2 years. Roeder setting up for this free kick. Two players in the SFU Wall. Just a handful of blue shirts in the box. Driven in, dangerous ball all the way across, flash across the face of goal, didn't get to anybody in the end. Red Leafs going to make a couple of changes here, trying to spark something with 16 minutes, 45 seconds remaining. It will be Hamish Ogden coming in alongside Cole Toupin. Sandu lifts it just to midfield, stopped up in the wind a little bit. Zohar straight up in the air, spinning above Roeder. Beautiful first touch from Ryan Roeder to bring that one down, but the pass intercepted by O'Hea. Zohar back to the captain, O'Hea. Roeder getting all the way back and being called for the foul on that one against O'Hea. O'Hea threatens to take it quickly with Roeder still on the ground, but now they will stop it up. This is one of those where you still have to be mindful of a possible attempt on goal, but the primary threat, of course, the ball into the middle. Clock stopped here at exactly 16 minutes. Ryan Roeder in a little bit of pain after that challenge. Looks like he'll get back up to his feet with no problem. Two-player wall for the Vikings. Everybody else in the middle to defend the ball in. This is a crucial one for SFU. They need to claw one back quickly if they're going to find a two-goal comeback. Ogden on the free kick, sent towards Locke. Locke not able to get there, sent straight up in the air, still in the mix. Hutter doing battle here with O'Hea, now back to Ogden. SFU player is down in the box. Players are calling for play to be stopped, and it is whistled dead here as a Simon Fraser player looks to be in some pain in the box. Not good to see here. Perhaps a blow to the head on that scruff of the ball. Players will go to their benches here. Not exactly sure the Simon Fraser player who is down with the injury, but we hope he can get back up to his feet. As the rain picks up yet again. Slippery conditions, not exactly what you want as the team defending a lead. Vikings have done well with it so far. Familiar with the rain as any Bellingham resident would be, are these Vikings. Brandon Locke gathers up the troops and talking to the team here, trying to see out these last 15 minutes, 42 seconds. As the SFU player is back up to his feet. It was Nikolai Plaksit, the player on SFU with the most minutes. Plaksit will be replaced. So 2-0 Vikings here. Ryan Roeder checks out. Wow, back in. 15 minutes, 42 seconds. A free kick or a drop ball, right at the edge of the box. An unusual situation to have a drop ball that is going to immediately threaten the goal. Ogden's on it, sends it in. Far post, headed straight into the ground. Danger on the line, kept out and headed away. Vikings once again make the stand. It is getting torrential out here. Pouring down buckets and buckets of rain. Last 15 minutes are going to be a wet one. Harrington crowd drenched to the bone, still watching their Vikings as they try to fight through here to what would be a marquee victory for them against a ranked Simon Fraser squad. Yellow card is going to be issued here to Quao Serrano on the challenge in his own defensive half. I'll tell you, this downpour is getting comical out here. I don't know if you can hear it hitting the tent above my head, which I am so thankful to have. But it is making everything difficult out here. Players and staff and fans as well. But we go on through these last 15 minutes. Yate in there, no foul on that challenge. Trying to spring a quick counter. Ball ahead, tried to find Janssen. Yate's efforts in vain that time. Hamish Ogden playing it back. And back to Ogden again. Oh, hey, at the top of the box. Ogden has a shot on the deck, left by Brandon Locke, out for a goal kick. Gonna see some more substitutions here. Checking back in will be Plaxett after that injury he sustained. On the corner kick, scrum for the ball. Diving ahead there to keep it going forward as Fernandez gets it to Bunnell working ahead. Can't get by the challenge of Ty Pound. Vikings crowd staying loud in these horrid conditions. Rain letting up just a little bit now. Thrown in quickly, trying to find Ohea, headed back by Tesfaye. In the middle, Hennessy on it. Hennessy, edge of the box, lays it off to Ohea, back to Hennessy. Two leading offensive threats for this SFU squad, and now sent into the box, an attempted bicycle kick, doesn't come off. And Quow sends it up into the rainy air. And now back with SFU. Near side, working at the corner. Torreson completely mishit that one. That is up by the ticket booth. And that is part of what you're gonna see these last 12 and a half minutes. Soaking wet ball, soaking wet players. Some misplays abound. First one there coming from Torreson. Ends the SFU opportunity. Play now restarted at 12 minutes, 16 seconds. Locke boots it off past midfield. Under it is Quow, tries to flick it on. Zohar won that aerial duel though. Hennessy moving ahead. 11 goals for him on the season. SFU need a spark right now. Hennessy tries to play it through, cleared away. And a foul is gonna be called against Hennessy there, going diving in to try to retrieve the ball that he touched a little bit too strongly into the feet of Jacob Sundberg. Locke boots it down towards Bunnell, chests it over to Sundberg. Another mishit there from Kyle Torreson, but it ends up with SFU and Ogden. Back with Torreson, trying to keep it in bounds on the near touchline, wins a throw in. Played ahead quickly. Poon. Got it past one, but too strong of a touch past the defender as Tidblom comes in to clean it up. Only as far as Ty Pound. Ogden, long ball, curling over. Far corner now. The captain, Ohea. pressed by Janssen. A striker wins it away, and he's off to the races. Down the wing, Bunnell spins off a challenge from Zohar and keeps it moving beyond midfield. Hiate in to help as well. Ball finds Hiate on the wing in the corner, working against Pound. Pound wins that battle, gets it over to Zohar. Zohar skips beyond Sundberg. Near side, Poon trying to work around Tesfaye. Can't do it. Help came from Sundberg. Quow goes down, no whistle. And Bunnell out for a Vikings throw. And it's looking like a five-player back line right now for Western Washington as Ryan Roeder will come back in to replace Quow Serrano. With under 10 minutes remaining, Vikings are oh so close to a marquee win against a ranked team here on senior night. Would be the first GNAC loss of the Red Leafs season. What a way to end your home slate. Andrew Roeder back out on the pitch, trying to get to that one. Tesfaye touches it down to Sundberg. Sundberg's attempted pass ahead, blocked out of bounds by Torreson. Greg Brisbane encouraging his side to get stuck in, see out these last 9 minutes. This is the level we know that they can play at. They've been doing it all night. Janssen on the wing with it. Works space for the cross. It's deflected away. Janssen in that converted winger role. Started the season off at that central striker position, but moved to the wing to try to get more touches as this one, once again, launched downfield by Locke right to his opposite goalkeeper in Sandu. Tidblom, heavy header, gets it back to Wall, way up in the air, going after to apply a bit of pressure as Kyoto Hiate now tracks back as Sandu claims it. Sandu way out of his area, trying to play through Ohea. Sent away by Tesfaye. That one played well by Roeder off the leg of Zohar and out for a Vikings throw. Still controlling this one, 6-11 in favor of Simon Fraser, but 2-0 is the scoreline right now. Vikings trying to hold on for another shutout against the highest scoring team in the GNAC as well, the only team with a better defensive record. Roeder, that's a well-weighted ball, trying to get it to his brother Andrew, but getting there in time was Ty Pound. That one up in the air, stays in bounds. Janssen on it, space for the winger to work. Drives to the end line. Unable to keep it in bounds. We're gonna see changes for the visitors and for the hosts.